Evans here. Yeah. So, I was trying to get you not to be so dark. I wonder why it's so dark. I guess the
shady day.
Yeah. All right.
To welcome everyone today to the December 5th workshop of the John Bekoff Project. We are we have several, like two main projects going on currently with the Bekoff Project for the advancement of Georgia old-time music. The first is to try to get people to play music in old-time community that's originally from Georgia. And then the other is to help some of the more promising younger fiddlers to really get the chops themselves so that they might teach others how to do that. So we have three fellows this year, and they are working privately with Mick and Evan Kinney. And they're doing a great job. I'm really impressed with their progress today. And then hopefully in the future, maybe like in heaven. You know, just because we can't always have. There's just a limited number of people who know Georgia tunes to lead jams. Hopefully they'll be able to do that very, very shortly. So this, so we have also like Jim Anderson. So Jim, it's so nice to put also with Andy Howard this document, which we keep the tunes with the chords and YouTube links, where we previously taught the tunes. All together on the put that on evankinney.com. So he has this, you can download that and see the tunes and source recordings to refer to. And it's a very nice document. So we're gonna
what dot com?
Evankinney.com.
Evan
on his website.
Evan's team.
Evan, so
oh, Evan Kinney's done. I'm yeah. Sorry, Evan Kinney. Gotcha.
And so we had a request for going over Methodist Preacher here, which is a great tune. I think we should
clean up
that
ring. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah,
sorry about that.
Well, hey
going.
There, Sanderson.
Now let's see here.
Howdy. Pie, we have people as far as Oregon here today in person, and I'm sure there's some of you online.
What do we owe this?
Or maybe California or North Carolina. So, okay, so while we're waiting for Evan Kinney, do you want to come up here and do the guitar?
Yeah, we're going to wait for him. He's on the way. But
this is, by the way, Mr. B. He's going to be making sure you go out of tune. In fact, maybe you're out of tune, he's going to start sparking.
He's got perfect pitch.
He probably can catch me.
Yeah.
Hey, Josh.
Hey, hey.
I'm a little bit at a disadvantage because I don't know all the tunes that you have accumulated, respectively or in total. So if you just, we can just, I'm counting on some of y'all to shout things out and what you want to, whatever y'all want to review for the first half or so. And then, unless you prefer, I can teach the new thing first. But I think it'd probably be good to just, for comfort level, maybe we'll just play some stuff we know. And that you want to review. Does that sound like a good idea? Do some review, Jim.
Sure, that sounds good.
If you know some of the titles, please holler them out. I know half a dozen that I recall. Like,
this might be a little prompt, memory prompt.
So I see fly around. Okay, are these things that we've just done lately?
Like previously at other.
Last time I was. What did this? Was that Waller's? Was that like before the pandemic? Was that,
yes.
I mean, that's 2 years ago.
Yeah.
So is this our first one?
No, we had Max lead one last month.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Oh, we had one canceled. That's right. We had Max lead one last month.
Sounds good.
Right. So let's see. We'll fly around with Pretty Little Miss, which is not to be confused with the one that's like called Western Gales. It's more or
Western country.
Western country, rather. Thank you, Susanna. Susanna Gales or Western country. Fly around a little bit. Just for difference, the other one. See. That's the one we're not going to do. That's the one that's the D tune. Y'all remember that one?
Yeah.
So this one is this tune is more associated with a tune called Jaybird Dud of the Whooping Call, which I know Vicky, but I don't know where she is.
Oh.
Actually, she's pretty far away.
Somebody's
there? We got a
spider here, so
y'all can get up here close.
Is that your case?
Not my case, sir.
So we're gonna do. Where's?
Let me get another chair.
Where did she go? Vicky was here.
She's inside.
Maybe she's doing something else. Okay, well, we'll play this. This is very much like Jaybird Dud of the Whooping Cough. It's basically all G. A quick rundown is if for those of you that has played it. We have a pentatonic tune starting on D descending. D, B, A, G, E. D, G, B, A, G. That's the first one to you. Then the other one is very similar, but it just starts on D. Tune like this where there's not a lot going on, you have to make something out of it with your own energy. So if you listen to the skill players, they bring a lot of rhythmic energy, they bring percussion to the tune, they bring a lot of little wiggles and variations and things like that. So there's another thing going on there. Is there another thing going on or something? Was there another thing going on inside? Everybody just come out
just grabbing the chairs.
It's called coffee.
Oh, okay.
Coffee.
Okay. I was looking for you, Vicky, because I know you knew these two. We're going to do Jaybird Dud of the Whooping Cough, is what it's called most places, but in the Skin and Liquor version, they call it Fly Around a Pretty Little Miss.
Oh.
Yeah. So, then after I do it, I'll show you some of the little wiggly parts, I call them. The people from Britain always go, show me the little wiggly bits. So, we'll talk about the wiggly bits.
I'll show you some wiggly bits.
Thank you. think I got the verse stanza wrong. No, it's fly around pretty little mist, fly around for days, yeah, I think.
Yeah.
Fly around pretty little mist, almost driving crazy. Then it's fare thee well, pretty little mist, fare thee well, my honey. If I don't see you by the middle of the week, look for me on Sunday.
That's today,
Sunday.
Sunday,
round with honey.
Sunday,
or
Monday.
Sunny,
honey.
Oh, well.
Hey, I just wanted to reintroduce to the people who just arrived. This is a jam that we hold monthly for the John Becker Project for the advancement of old time, Georgia old time music, which is specific to the 1920s and 30s music recorded in Georgia. And I'm doing a little YouTube live here for my subscribers. So I just want to explain to them that your likes and comments on my silly little dance video uploads actually help promote them in the Google algorithm. And so the money from advertising that comes in from my YouTube channel supports this project. So I, through the project, with the help of the Frank Hamilton School, I support our mentors who work with y'all so that you can learn this. So I want to thank you all for your silly comments, because we need them. And I'll do some dancing during the jam to keep all, some of the people that are watching live, so I'll provide a little percussion as we get going. I did want to introduce Frank Hamilton. So this school, which supports this project, is here's our one of our founders, Frank Hamilton. He was with the Weavers in the 60s, 70s, other, like, what started the Chicago old time, actually it's called a school of music, sorry,
old town school
of music. Yeah, so I just wanted to give a shout out to our fearless leader in music. Great. Making music for all. So that's kind of like one of the motivators for my channel, is that we want to make the expertise of experts like Mick Kinney available to people all around the world, who can therefore, like, music's for all, and anyone is available, you know, it's free for all. We try to make it accessible to all. So that's just I want you to say that since you're all here. Take it away, Mick. Sorry.
Georgia music, it's
not
great.
Not to negate what you said about the 20s and 30s, but that is the golden era of recorded music, folklore, before the mass broadcast era. So, that is, but this is an ongoing tradition. A lot of the music that Levin and I collected were from field recordings and actual living people, living sources. And even to this day, we still try to look for people that remember tunes in their family, or they have manuscripts, or home recordings of people, and as I like to call it, collecting from the collectors. I like to go out and collect from people like Art Rosenbaum and universities and places that have things in vaults, apparently. A lot of times you find in academia, people collect something and then they write a paper on it and then they put it away and they never get it out. So I'm sort of trying to, like, be a little bit of a conduit in that regard, like to go to West Georgia College or University of Georgia and see what they have there in their field recordings. And sometimes you can. The big influence of mine was Howard Raines from Texas. He kind of did this in Texas, and Harry Bullock did it in Mississippi. And that's kind of like part of my template for what I had in mind about collecting from collectors, is what I call it. I just like, because these things are just sitting there, and you can do this, you can pick up something that you're interested in and do the same thing, because a lot of the hard work has been done by the scholars have done a lot of work in collecting things. And
we got some people from England watching, so why don't you play us another tune? Like, get on with it. He said, stop talking. Can we play another tune?
Yes, we can. I was kind of hoping that y'all would be thinking of one, but otherwise I'm looking for prompts from y'all. If not, see the next one. Since we're in G, I'm going to skip down to the next G we have, which is G-Ray.
Yeah.
So we'll do that. But I did want to talk about the wiggly bits for the English people there. Some of the stuff that we had, because is this appropriate amount of time to spend on one tune, or do we?
It's getting maxed, but. Getting maxed out. Just in a minute.
So part of the things that I hear on the skillet lickers, of course, you have a lot of different fiddles going at one time there. They do this little kind of a bluegrassy double stop, I think, or it's maybe more than one fiddle, but I hear a high G in there. So they'll do that on the high D part. Then they like another thing that I like to call, and these are little nuggets come up in a lot of these Georgia tunes. They're little isms. There's like a little flutter that they do. And it could come from the high to the low object note, or it could be low. And the jibber does whoopy cup. So if you do that, you can get your index, you get your middle finger up there in that position, and you can reach that high G up there. Another thing that they do is they scuff around the jibber down to the whooping cough. So that sort of thing is those kind of textural things I like to talk about as they come up in the tune. So if you hear something, I might just do it extemporaneously, so you can just call me out on that if you hear something. What was that little wiggly bit or that little scuffy thing? Because those are like another one that I like that's very quintessential. Gibb Tanner is he does like a very slow drawl on his fiddle. He goes. It happens in a lot of their music. So if you listen to the original source, you'll start to get into these things. And they're really fun to pepper in on your tune there. Is that Leslie there? Hey, they recognize you there, Dr. Watson.
Susan Sanderson. Susan.
Yeah.
Not at all.
Okay, so we're going to do one by, it's actually very highly circulated tune nowadays. It has a historic footnote that you all probably already know, but it's, for those of you all that might be tuned in or whatever, this is considered arguably the first integrated tune, which is ironically comes out of the Deep South. And it's our Calhoun people up in they have a festival that celebrates this band called the Georgia Yellowhammer. And they did like a kind of a collaboration. Andrew Baxter played on one of their records, and it's called the G-Rang. And because apparently from my secondhand source, that was new, a firsthand source, Andrew Baxter was legendary for his rendition of G-Rang. So they wanted to get him on the record. And I don't know if I ever told this anecdote, but this comes from Mike Jones, who's Clayton Jones' father. And he's still alive, and he knew Moody, which he knew a member of the Yellowhammers.
Let's play.
And he said that they pushed Andrew Baxter up close to the mic. And it was a very controversial thing at the time to have a integrated record at that, at so early. This is, I think, 27 or 28. So, so here's a G-Rag, I'll do it, maybe just play a little bit under the radar and then just kind of pepper it, just kind of filter it. So here we go. Here's a G-Rag. 3, 4.
that sound good.
Oh. So, if anybody was interested in more about that tune, about the tunes, and you want information, you're supposed to have that. Like, you don't want to have that on during the show. You want to have it afterwards, or email me, or because I can talk about these tunes. I like. It's like collecting baseball cards or something. You have a story about everything. So, but that's a very interesting tune, and it's quintessential Georgia, related to Chinese Breakdown, which is a Georgia tune, related to many other tunes of its kind like that. That has that same kind of chord structure. Up Jump the Devil and Wisey Hamilton Special, and I think other ones. Georgia Bust Down, Georgia Stump. If you'd like to do anybody takers for any of those, y'all feed me with information. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to feed me with requests. You got requests.
I got one, Mick.
Sit next to that.
How about Farewell?
We don't really need a monitor.
Last time we learned Farewell Tryon.
No, we're not doing that.
I don't play that. Well,
today it's not one of the Kinneys. They don't like it.
Oh,
it's not a Georgia tune, okay. Anyways. Actually, it comes from James Bryant. But
mix that.
No, I like to listen to it. I just don't play it. So anybody else got a request there?
Thanks for all the shout outs from the UK. Sorry, I can't moderate the comments. Sorry about that. I deleted some by mistake.
Have y'all got Picking Up Peanuts or Bust Down Stomp, Georgia Stomp, any of those?
Hellboy Blues in Georgia? Is that a Georgia tune?
Well, just with respect to the banjo in tunes, is that a Georgia tune? That's quintessential Georgia tune.
Is it?
Yes, it is. I was just speaking about tunes that are related to G-Rag, and the banjos are in G, so I'm just going to respect
Possum on
that.
A Rail?
Tallapoosa Bound is a G tune.
I was responding to his request about
I see. Georgia. I see. Some play it in G. Some people play it in G.
All right.
So shall we do any takers for any of those?
How do, Jordan Captain Cleveland?
Picking Up Peanuts. Field Sparrow.
I can't believe how many people are watching.
The reason I'm asking these is, are they in your book? Are they in your collection?
That last one you mentioned was not at all.
Hey, Western NC.
How about Possum on a Rail? That's a
Possum on a Rail?
Possum on a Rail, yeah.
We can do that. It's one of y'all's. Everybody cool with that? Possum on a Rail? Also known as Coon on a Rail. So. Possum on a Rail is kind of a Bob and Cabbage kind of thing. I like to start on a low part, but I'm going to start on a high part because that's historical. So it's kind of like It's All Me, you know that song. That's the high part. And then the other part's like a bow limb cabbage. Like the same kind of chord progression is like that. So here we go. 2, 3, 4.
Thank you. Catherine. I just want to welcome Evan Kinney. We got people as far as England watching, so.
If you have one in your mind, you can have it teed up, and we'll have it ready. If you all want, no questions about that one. It's a double controversy. I heard Tallapoosa bounce, so we'll do that, because I just came through Tallapoosa yesterday. What's that? What was that?
Oh, it's Zoom talking. Just ignore that. That's just a Zoom lady.
So we'll do Tallapoosa.
It's just Siri.
Home of K-3. Well, out that way anyways. Bowdoin, if you know where Bowdoin, Georgia is, it's near the Alabama line. So we're going to do Tallapoosa Bound. It has a structure where the chords, when you chord people, same chords on the A to B part. We're going to pass through a two chords, so that's A7, A to D. And the chord structure is G1, 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 C, 4, and G, and 1, and B, and back to G. So that's the chord chart. That's my air chart for that one. So you got it. So halfway through the line, halfway through each section, you're going to go past from A to D. So, and this one's usually done at kind of a breakdown speed, but we'll do it at the same speed just since we're kind of just reviewing it, right? Then maybe we'll kick it up a notch. It changes the feel of it. So if you tell it, who's abound?
Thank you. don't have a monitor.
Yeah. We can turn that monitor around and shoot it out.
I can sort of hear. I can.
Sort of's not good enough, though. Let's have it. Just speak up. Or turn it up. You can turn it up either one, whichever. Because the speakers aren't up on a stand, so I'm not sure. I'm not sure if they're shooting out to you. I'm going to move that speaker out to the back row. I want to put it in the side. I have the side washed through. So that one has some nice idiosyncrasies from the great championship fiddler, AA great. Alphonse, A.A. Gray was, unfortunately he wasn't recorded that often, but he has some really good kind of personality things in that. He has a very cool syncopation cadence, if you could get that into your fiddling. So it's not just... Like a lot of times people will just kind of simplify things, but it's really cool if you can catch that little, give me a metronome and I'll show you the breakdown of that syncopation if you want. 2, 3. It's a lot of like a ragtime sequence cadence in there. So it's very cool if you can get that. He plays it at a breakdown speed, so it's. Is it about the speed he does it, something like that? Not quite that fast. Okay. Anyways, it's pretty up tempo. I don't know if you saw that one. So you can feed. We have the book there, so if you want to keep the numbers coming.
I do like the Methodist preacher. Is that not one you do? Is that Evans?
Whenever we change keys, we're just respecting banjos, but we only have Josh here, so if we can have two banjos or whatever. We have Frank, you change keys or you stay in G, right?
We're great on banjos.
Oh, we got, okay.
I think it's a good time to change keys anyway.
Yeah, you want to change keys?
I can change keys. Yeah.
What's Methodist? Rabbit
or car? Yeah, those are both D's.
Those rabbit's G.
I'm on that one.
I
mean, no problem. I like to go back and forth all around. I just want to respect.
Yeah, this is an intermediate banjo, so I think they can all retune pretty well.
We're the always be outcasts.
I'll go with the majority, whatever you want to do. I was going to mention other G tunes that we might want to do. Brandon and I have been playing Sweetest Girl in the Catio. That's a really fun one. And Frank 2. It's Frank 1, Frank 2, Frank 3, and Frank 4. But we've been playing Prettiest Girl in the Catio. That's a good G one. But, you know, we could play 4 hours in G, so it's up to y'all. And when I was hoping to introduce at some point, maybe just on your future radar, I like the streak of leaves, streak of fat in key of G. That's a good one. Anybody know that too? Is that it? If you wanted to collect that, we can do that. I don't know what the balance of review versus new is, so whatever you would you like to. How many new tunes do you suggest?
I'll let Brennan decide. Yeah.
How many new?
You're the vice leader. You're our vice leader. Tell us.
I mean, we can start with one and see how that goes, and maybe introduce.
Okay. Would you all like to learn a new G tune? Would you like to learn a streak of leaves? Great. We can do that.
Yeah, sure. That's a great one.
Or we can use the soap suds over the fence. That's another good G tune.
So the streak of leaves is one that a lot of us have heard of.
Let's see. Well, this is the G one. Yeah,
the G one, right?
A lot of people have not heard.
Right, not helpers.
This is the stroke shots over the fifth. I can put them both down.
Oh, I thought that was a C tune. It's in G. Well,
there's a lot of doppel numbers, so you can't be careful with all that stuff. Yeah, there's more than one of both of those names are recycled. Those are both recycled names. So they recycle and repurpose the melodies and repackage. So, but this is the Georgia's George, and there's two in Georgia. There's a C, streak of lean, streak of fat, A grade in that one. You see. That's like Hell Broke Loose in Georgia. That's the same tune, basically. But we'll do, the Streak of Lean, Streak of Fat actually is a key changing tune. The way I interpret it, it has a change, key change on the B part. So here it is. Starts in G, then the second one. I'll do it moderate here. 2, 3, 4. Kettle on, man. Molly put the kettle on. Here, they all have tea. just stays on G the whole time, but I'm hearing Clayton McRitch and singling that D. To me, it sounds like he's really signifying a D. So I'm thinking that's probably how historically it should be. Even though a lot of times I'm not satisfied necessarily with the accompaniment that's always on the source material. Sometimes they were pickup bands. So yeah, if anybody has trouble with this lick, that's pretty easy diagonal. You can do it with the open string if you want to rock your bow. Or you can do it if you want to use your little finger, either one. So either way is easier for you. It's good to get the little finger working, so. But if you want to play it kind of scruffy, you can just do it that way. I think it goes by so fast it doesn't really matter much. Memphis plays this pretty fast too. To sustain the energy of a higher speed performance, when you slow it down, it's actually easier when you get that momentum of the bow and you have that, it's actually easier to sustain. So don't be afraid of, not that speed is a virtue, but sometimes when you slow things down too much, if you lose the kinetic energy, it doesn't sound authentic to the bowing style. So you gotta spot the difference and just experiment around with that. Like it's just like on banjo, you know, you get your rhythm pocket going, it's a little bit, has its own internal support, you know. So same thing with fiddling, you want to make it easier on you. If you're having to sustain the long notes and it's unnatural, just speed it up a little bit. Sometimes things are actually easier to play a little faster. So should we do this a time or two and time or two again? Because this one, I know this is a notier tune than I don't like a lot of notey tunes, but this one, I just named a G tune. Sure, you could hear when I said A2 or one more A2.
You might put that mic a little closer to you if you can.
Keep turning it up. If they need more, do it over there. Because I like my elbow room. I like my elbow room. There's plenty of headroom on it. You can go up. Is that better? Is it?
we need to descend the mic maybe.
So since we're still in G, I mentioned these are kind of companion pieces in my mind because they're both kind of the same skill liquor tunes. This one is you played that, by the way. You played that. So did you play that Streakling Speaking Band and version of G? Because some other Mitchianisms he does. He does the thing that he does on Rye Straw. Mick Mitchell's got one of the best Rye Straws. I know you like that too. Because Woody Guthrie, you know, who was a fiddler, played that Rye Straw. But the Georgia Rye Straw via Mick Mitchell is very cool. And he has like some kind of barking. He does some scuffy thing. Very hard to do slow. I mean, you can't scuff slow. It's like some tap dance moves don't work slow.
Yeah,
you
can't do it.
You gotta have the physical body movement. So, it's kind of that. But he does some Mitchianism like that on that. That one was pretty notey, pretty transparent. But this is another one that I like. Is I was just thinking about G tunes when they were trouble. Because Soap Suds Over the Fence.
Hey, so, Indiana.
Not to be confused with other ones. They recycle the names. So this one is, it's kind of like In the Woodpile a little bit, or Railroad Under Cotton. It's got the same kind of, it helps me to compartmentalize my tunes. Sometimes they get crossover confusion, but it helps me keep them straight, because it's like, you know, I also think like, it's kind of got that same riff. It's like, so that's, it has a little bit of a conversation. It's like a little, you know, like in church, you know, I got a witness. I hear you. So, you know. That's the A part. That's all.
I got a witness.
So let's just learn that first phrase. Now this is the hardest part of this tune is jumping up there and getting back cleanly. So the fillers, I go ahead and put my ring finger down, because you gotta do that Katie Hill move. You gotta put, I plant all three of these fingers down right away, because you're gonna be using a little flutter there. So you plant your fingers there and try that little move. Probably jump up there and you have the muscle memory, so let's do it real quick to low part. Internal call and response. Okay. Then we have a. So we got G, high G. Okay, I'm doing it modularly, just breaking it down without the flow. So we got G, A, da, 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 da. A, B, A, da, da, G, G, da, da. And then short and right home, just to play it all. Sour mountain ending, you know.